Wish I had a mango tree in my backyard with you standing next to me. Take the picture from the lips I heard her say, can I have you caught up on what to say? I said you do. I said you do. I said you do. Through my eyes I can see a shooting star weaving its way across the sea. Somewhere from Mars, down the street we've run. Scratch our names in the park, young and free in the sun. Wheels upon the tar. I said you do. I said you do.
Very I can nice. Be anybody you want.
So come on then, a quick
Ronda, how are you feeling about it?
How are you feeling?
Cool.
any more than that? Any thoughts for the day? Message for Wizzy?
Yeah, good luck with Mike.
Yeah. I'd share that sentiment.
Yeah. Good chaps.
My message to them is to have the happiest day and the happiest life together. And I will always be here for them.
Wish them all the best.
Yes.
And have a wonderful honeymoon.
Have a really great time travelling around Europe. I'm going to miss you for that month you're away, and I look forward to your return, and have a really great time.
Wish I had a mango tree in my backyard with you standing next to me. Take the picture from her lips I heard her say, can I have you caught up in what to say? I said you do. I said you do. I said you do. I said you do.
Wait for me!
Will the congregation please stand for the entrance of the bride?
And the devil boy will come with me and we'll make many storms.
Yeah. I might go with you, Louisa. I might go with you to be my wife, to have hope. From this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer. Sickness and in love and till death us do for you is our holy. The presence of our name is now. I Louisa, take you my be my husband. Have the hope. From this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Till death us do part. According to God's holy will. In the presence of God, I make this vow.
said, I am the devil boy. Come with me and we'll break men in love. He offered me eternal life.
Heavenly Father, by your blessing, let these rings be Michael and Louisa, a symbol of an ending love and faithfulness, to remind them of the vow and covenant which they have made through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Louisa, I give you this ring as a sign of love. With my body, I offer you. All that I am, I give you. And all that I have, I share with you. Within the love of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Never give up you. I'll taste the devil's tears.
Michael, I give you this ring as a sign of honor. With my body, I love you. All that I have, I give you. And all that I have, I share with you. Within the love of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. In the presence of God and before this congregation, Michael and Louisa have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife.
Oh,
How was the wedding? You guys enjoy it?
Oh, yeah, it's great. We're making a video, I guess. Oh, God.
So, how?
Totally managed to find it without, you know, any problems. No stress. It's been plain sailing.
We were all the emails.
Easy. Like, so easy.
No one got ready in the van on the way.
No, there was no wrong turn.
No mistimes. No
spanks.
Nobody poked themselves.
No. Blame you. Hollywood, for showing me things you never should show a young girl. You're in this cruel world. This last night, a happy ending. I'm sure there's some like Johnny and
yeah. thing that she's asked me to stand up and give this short speech and ask Alex if he would do something pretty easy and insignificant, which I believe is to provide all the catering and all the arrangements for the entire day. Thank you, Lizzie, for your vote of confidence, and thank you, Alex, for your small contribution. So when Lizzie announced that Mike and her were getting married, I did wonder if I was going to be asked to do this speech in place of our late father. And I was still surprised and honoured when she asked me to do it. That was right up until I realised that tradition stated that I was going to have to stand up in front of about 130 people and say nice things about my little sister, which I don't think really comes naturally to any good brother. And suddenly, that patron girl of Alex didn't look so hard up for it. As always, with these such events, a huge amount of work has gone into the background over the last year or so. And I'd just like to start by again just thanking everybody for being here today. I know a lot of people have travelled a long way, and it's just fantastic that you can all be here to join us to celebrate their wedding. The number one person who I think needs a mention and a thank you is Wizzy. She has worked tirelessly over the last year or so. Everything you can see here today, from the artwork up on the walls, the menus, the plants, the decorations, everything, really is her vision. And it was her hard work that's really brought all this together. And I think you all agree that it looks fantastic, she looks fantastic, and we're all super proud. And I'm really, really proud of this. Over on the left, on the shelves, are the wedding favours. Now, these are little individual money plants that Wizzy planted by hand and then decorated every single gel. So we're all under strict orders not to leave without taking at least one of them. I've been told there's going to be checks, so but please make sure you take one before you leave. My mum, here, Alex, Mike's parents, have all been instrumental in every single stage of planning this wedding. And I think a special mention she's going to my mum, because she's led the charge on everything, and due to Wizzy's obsession with plants around the room, she's had to live in pretty much a rainforest for the last 6 months. And I really think she's looking forward to getting her house back and finding out what did happen to the cat. So just thank you for everyone who's had anything to do with it, and of course everyone who's been here today. So I don't think it could have worked out any better. It's wonderful. We've been very lucky to grow up in the family that we've grown up in. Alex, Wizzy and I are all very close, we share interests, we see each other on a really regular basis. I've always felt a huge responsibility for Wizzy being a big brother. I'm 7 years older than her. And one of my earliest memories was being chipped off to a neighbour's with Alex in the middle of the night, and our mum and dad disappearing and coming back several hours later with a Wizzy, complete with this crazy hair and sticking out tongue, and it's noticed something that's imprinted in my mind. So Alex and I took our roles as big brothers very seriously. And they are, And Wizzy slotted into her role as our, I guess, chief crash test dummy, guinea pig, Wizzy. And her victim, whatever hair-raising scheme we came up with, she was always right there with us. She's a tough little thing, Wiz, and I don't know whether that's an innate quality or whether it's due to growing up with two older brothers who used to push her into everything. But I know that my fondest memories of growing up with her are always the little adventures and activities and things that we used to get up to. And just a couple of examples where Wizzy and I went snorkeling in the Caribbean when she was about 10. And I took her off skiing, I think in her second week of skiing in Austria. And again, she's just always there, smiling, laughing, and has just always been the perfect activity partner for me, which is great. I can only think of a single occasion where Alex and I maybe pushed her a little bit too far. And that was when we decided that we were going to try and find out just how fast you could tow somebody on the back of the bike whilst they're wearing rollerblades. Obviously, Lizzie was right there, ready to hold onto the rope, and never said slow down. Right up until the moment when we broke arm. Raised her knees and elbows and face, and it's still something that I feel genuinely terrible about. Being Lizzie, she made so little fuss about this particular broken arm, but it took my mum, with her nursing training and medical background, a full week before she actually took her to the hospital and had the arm fixed. I think there's some guilt all around on that particular one. It's been an absolute joy growing up with Lizzie and seeing her creativity and drive every single day. She's got an amazing sense of humour, a fearsome wit, and an absolutely innate element. Whether she was writing and delivering the most beautiful, funny, and emotional eulogy at our granddad's funeral, or whether completely destroying me with a witty one-liner, she just never misses a beat. But as well as that, she's got this huge loving side. And every birthday and Christmas, I would open all the cards from the family. And it would be the usual sea of sarcasm, rude jokes, and general filth from everybody. Except for one. There was always one card that always had a teddy, or a puppy, or something soppy on the front of it. And the message inside always started the same. To my big brother, love Lizzie. And it was just a little thing, but something that always touched me, and always will always stay with me. And actually, giving some of the cards she's been giving out today, I think she's carrying that on. A lot of people are going to experience that. I'm so happy to say that that closeness that we grew up with has developed into a firm friendship with a huge amount of love and a huge amount of laughing. Even it does mean that the two of us definitely can't be trusted anywhere near a case of Prosecco, especially as we were supposed to be cooking Christmas lunch for the whole family that year. So, yeah, sorry, Mum. It's truly an honour to be able to stand here, well, to be giving Wizzy away for the wedding today, especially to Mike. My son has been around our family for years and really truly is part of the family. And I love the fact that I'm the person who gets to stand here today and officially welcome Mike into the family. Even if Mike on occasion does drink a little bit too much and decides he's going to break into our house by my bedroom window at 3 o'clock in the morning and give me the scare of my life. So, before we stand and make the first official toast to the newly happy married couple today, I just want to wish you all the best in the future. And I'd like to hand over to my mum, who, anyone who knows my mum, will know she has a bit of an art for writing poetry. So I'm sure what we're about to hear will be very serious, very intellectual. And we shall see. So, mum.
So here we are on this special event to send Ralph and Vivi on their way. It's not being straightforward, they're big ups and downs, with plenty of sides. Eddie needs to be quiet. It's not been straightforward, they've been ups and downs, with plenty of smiles and a few puzzled frowns. They met several years ago while working in a pub. I guess their eyes met over the booze and the grub. They both had red hair, which was bright and eye-catching, and fell for each other through beer and pork scratchings. Their shared love of music brings them pleasure and joys. They write, play, and sing songs that others enjoy. Their guitars are their friends, and using plectrums and strings, they produce lovely sounds, giving the music its wings. My paper. Things did go wrong with their future in question. it seemed they might part. But Mike made a suggestion. I'll go to Australia and make sausage rolls. And we said, OK, let's see how that goes. She was lost when he left. She missed her best friend. The tears freely fell as she wished he'd return. And so he came back. She was over the moon. The proposal came later, not a moment too soon. And so they're married. Their husband and wife. As Mr. and Mrs., they'll start their new life. Please join me to wish them good things all the way, with our love behind them. What more can I say?
I'm so glad. And can I ask everybody to charge their glasses and we'll make the first official toast to Lizzie and Mike, the bride and groom. So, Lizzie and Mike, the bride and groom. I think we can all agree that that was an incredibly beautiful poem. Thank you, Jill. I really, really enjoyed that. So, at the group, I have the privilege of actually doing the thank yous today. Robbie has already done an incredible job on the thank yous already. There are a few people that I personally like to thank for being here today and making all this happen. While I've never wanted to undermine the fantastic financial contribution that has made this event occur and make it possible, this whole wedding has been built on a labour of love and incredible talent, and like a lot of my very good friends providing their incredible skills like to make this all completely happen. And what's quite interesting about this wedding is that there have actually been no external people that we've hired. Everyone has done anything here, everything from the photography to the decoration of the stage, the food, has been a friend of everyone here. So the first person I would really like to thank is Tom Flashman. I see you over there. So Tom made our wedding rings. Like, he made them himself, forged in the fires of Kensington. And they're beautiful, they're matte gold, and we sat made those in the pub with the Iron Tom, discussing them, sketching them out and making them perfect, and we can all agree they're absolutely beautiful. So thank you, Tom, like a really unique gift. Thank you very much. Yeah. The second person I'd really like to thank is Tom Fenton on the stage up there. Thank you, Tom. Like, not only has Tom done all the videography today, but his band are headlining the night, and they're a fantastic band. I can't wait for you all to see them. But Tom supplied all the music equipment as well, and basically at the job of that, provided all of the cables and microphones and the ability to use the PA today. So Tom has made this night work. So thank you, Tom. Robbie's already mentioned the paintings, but Babs and Ella D, my new niece, have provided fantastic paintings as well. As well as Wizzy. Wizzy has done the lineup, the menu, all tirelessly, and four of my grubby little flat and working. Like, endlessly. They still look fantastic. So, one person I would like to thank personally as well, who is the partner of a very old friend of mine who didn't really know anyone here, but as a surprise, I had all these balloons being blown at the helium outside with folks to me and Wiz. It's Pearl, who me and Hugo have been organising for months to be outside blowing up all these helium balloons. Which has got... And so, while we were off at church, Pearl was outside with a helium tank blowing up balloons. I was trying to keep it from everyone, including Jill, and I was wondering what would happen if people showed up and this mysterious woman was blowing up balloons. So thank you, Pearl. The musicians as well, all people who are friends coming to play tonight and provide fantastic music for us. We also have, I've already mentioned Emily. Thank you, Emily, fantastic photographer, being really honoured all day. Thank you, Emily. So that beautiful music you heard in the church as well, that was one of my ushers, Kel's, playing guitar. Like, I asked him to play organ, but he didn't want to do it. So like, because you've never played an organ before in your life, have you? Like, so, yeah. So guitar would have to do. But that was fantastic as well. So like, yeah. And incredibly, like, from the bottom of my heart, Molly and Jack, who just, all of this, as I knew they would just put their heart and soul into making all these beautiful decorations. Like, they're always so busy and so lovely, and they've just, like, dropped everything as usual and made everything you can see around us incredibly beautiful. And last night with the ushers and the bridesmaids, they were here till, like, up to midnight, making everything you can see absolutely fantastic. And, like, it was a labour of love, and we wouldn't be able to do it without them. So thank you, Molly and Jack. My best man James has taken the task on completely perfectly. Like, I knew he put his heart into it as well, and the stag do was just stupidity. And like tonight has been an incredible organisation as well as yesterday as well. So James, thank you so much. You've also organised the bridesmaids as well and done an incredible job. So like, keeping everything together too. But thank you, Fabs. Hand carved all the cupboards over there, which hold all the wedding planes as well. Steve has had to live in like that scene from Jumanji for the last month or so, like, living in like all these flowing planks as like we prepare for the wedding. And like, obviously, Robbie's mentioned, but out. All this food was not prepared, but like the whole like meal was completely designed by Alex and his fantastic cooking part of his, and we can all agree that it's been absolutely perfect tonight. It's amazing. So, the last person I'd personally like to thank is Jill. Like, Jill has been a pinnacle of just brilliance throughout this whole wedding, has completely had this thing in check from square one. She's made this. Without Jill and Wizzy working together in a partnership, like this, there would be no way. So like, I would like to myself raise a toast to Jill, my new mother-in-law. Jill! Thank you so much. Let's hold that. And I have a gift for Jill. Jill has a gift for Jill. So this is a gift for you, Jill. No. And also some lovely flowers as well.
James.
Now I'm behind the stage. They can't hear us now. Stop that. I'd also like to deliver my fantastic, my mother as well, who's also like been fantastic on this whole album, so a gift for my mum too. So, I could tell a million stories about me and Wizzy, and it'd be too hard to choose. So the story I will tell is of the night that me and Wizzy actually met. So, I actually am incredibly fortunate to have a photograph of the exact moment that Wizzy and I first met. And it's right here. So this photo was taken pretty much the moment me and Wizzy first had our conversation.
Yeah.
We were introduced by a mutual friend of ours, Alice Armstrong, who again is coming down with her musical partner to play music for us later on. So she introduced her, she took this photo. And we immediately realised we had a lot in common, mainly Red Passion Hair Dye by L'Oreal. And Mr. Bump merchandise. And funny enough, that night we were like invited me back to a party at her house because Jill was away. marched with a friend, Josh Daly, who we all know, and we went. And by the time we got there was no one there. They were all still at the park, so we went home again. I had a funny feeling that like we should go back, so we did go back and they were there again. And also, Alex was there as well. I know, Jill, shopping. A legal party. And so, after party we left, and like probably that much at the end of it, but I left my young person's rail card there, so I had to go back for the next day. And then after that, we'll be like, it was pictures. So we met up, hung out, and we all came thick as thieves. And that was January 2008 that photo was taken. And since that time, like, I seen the movie, I seen you do the company from the ground up very successfully. I seen you filming on the main stage of Gigfest. Like, I seen you carted off by six policemen when we were evicted from the hippie squat back in 2011. But I never thought I'd see this day at all. So I would like to raise a glass to my new wife and best friends. Yeah. So to my dick. I'd like to hand over to my best man and best friend.
Yeah. I just want to start off by thanking the bridesmaids who look fabulous today. I also want to say thank you to Mike and Lizzie for having all of us here. It's been an amazing day. It's been amazing in the church. It's been really good. So raise your glasses to the happy couple. I will probably do this again at the end of the speech, so we'll do it once now. Right. Okay. I first came across this wonderful human when we were still at school. I think it was 2 years into school, and I decided that I wanted to put a band together. And I found Kells and Sam, who are both sitting there. Kells, you can see from where we're at, he's got wonderful hair. And I said to myself, right, I'm going to put that together and, you know, I'm going to take over the school and become the best band ever in the world. And I met another guy at my house who had just been skiing with Mike. And he said to me, you've got to talk to Mike because Mike's, you know, he's into music, he wants to be in a band, etc, etc, etc. And he wants to play bass. And I said, okay, fine, I'll come and meet Mike. So he said, give Mike a call. And I said, okay, I'll give Mike a call. And I remember the very first conversation I had with you. I called you up and I said, do you like Guns N' Roses? And you're like, of course I like Guns N' Roses. Well, okay. He was like, and he said this to me, do you like Motley Crue? And I was like, well, I've heard a song of recently of a game that I was playing. And I basically said, yeah, I love this band, I want to form a band with you. And yeah, I think from that moment we met up, started playing together, and I'm gonna be honest, when we first met each other, we basically hated each other, I think. we were in the same band together, we used to fight the entire time. There was one point where I went over to his house, I was in a house called Rockhouse, this was a child's house, he was in a house called Rockhouse. And I went over there and we got in such a big fight, we ended up moving to the bleed just by boxing each other. I think it was that moment where it was like, hang on a minute, we get on. Through all of this, we did get on. Now, I'm going to get to the part of the speech where I want to talk about embarrassing moments with Mike. So, I thought about this long and hard, but what can I really say about Mike that would really, really embarrass him? I'm not going to do it to you, I'm to be honest. Basically, there is a person that Mike has never met, that Mike knows very well, but he's never met. So I'm just going to say two words. If you don't know Mike, fair enough. But if you do know Mike, you'll know the words drunk Mike. You haven't actually got any Mike to drink. I'm not going to say anymore because I think there's two. I think every one of you who knows drunk Mike will know, or will at least be able to recount skips, bushes, hugging a security guard. ceiling. I could tell you one, actually. There's one when we were in Verona. Should I?
Yes!
And we were in a bar, and John Mike had appeared out of nowhere. He just appeared, by the way. And we said, he ran into a little story, and he ran out again, he thrust into my hand this bottle of water, and I think a bottle of rum, wasn't it? And he went, "You're in charge," and ran off. And I was going, what does that mean? The bartenders were sorely holding these two bottles and went, "Right, you're out." And I was like, okay, come on, that's fine, I'll do this. At which point, you disappeared for the rest of the night until the very end of the night when you suddenly appeared. At this point, I was allowed back into the campsite because of what had happened. Everyone else was fine. I was not allowed, so anyway. So that's the embarrassing part of the way. Drunk Mike isn't here, and... yet. I can see possibly, but I can't see him. No. Oh,
okay.
That's true. Yeah, I think he was trying to get out. I think I could see him like dropping like a stag do. He was like, "Oh my god,
his sleeve is too clean."
Yeah, that. Yeah, I won't repeat that. But what I really want to say is that this man here is one of the most beautiful people I've ever met. I don't know if he's cringy or not, but he's generally beautiful. When my girlfriend Louisa was in the hospital earlier this year, he went to go and visit her. I didn't ask him to, he just went out his way. I recently, about 2 years ago, I left the band. And while I was in that band, my biggest fan was this man. He was always there. He was in Australia. He was texting me saying, "How's it all going?" And when I left that band, he was so mortified. He said to me the other day, "I'm so mortified that the other tribes are still going." I said, "Well, you know, it isn't going for whatever reason." You just said, "But I support you all the way, and I support you with everything I do. And I see that with you and Wizzy. I really do. And you've been there this whole year, and before that, and everything, you know, through all of what everyone else was saying before, you've been there constantly. And I have nothing but respect for you as your best man. And I'm honored to be your best man." That's it. Tonight and Wizzy. Let's get some pudding and then let's go on with this. And again, thank you everyone, and thank you Mark and Wizzy, because they wouldn't be.
Climbing back up to the mountain. you are, freshly married. How do you feel? How was it?